Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Good morning, dear students, and welcome to the Smart School Virtual Classroom Teaching. Today, we are going to discuss a very informative and interesting topic. But before moving on to our today's topic, please follow the instructions given right here on your screen. You must have to carefully watch the presentation. You must have to listen attentively to your teacher. So, our today's topic is microbes and diseases. Dear students, the word microbes basically arrives from the word microorganisms. And we all know that microorganisms are very tiny living organisms present in our environment. These microbes maybe sometimes are very useful and sometimes that can cause several types of diseases in our bodies. So let's discuss in detail. We have objectives right here on your slide. We are going through each of them in detail. First of all, I will clear you that what are microbes. Then I will get some little bit introduction about types of microbes. Then the main thing that what is the process through which this transmission take place means the one microbes is present in the one's body and what is the process through which it travels to another's body. So basically we will discuss these modes of transmission through which these microbes transmit from one's body to another. Then we will discuss about the useful microbes and the harmful microbes. As there are the harmful microbes means there must be the disease causing microbes. As the microbes causes the disease, so we must have to develop a defense system against those type of diseases. So let's start. First of all, I will tell you that what are microbes. The word microbes is a short of microorganisms. These are very tiny living things that can only be seen with a microscope. Means if you want to see it with your naked eye, you can't. If you want to see it, you must have to use a microscope. There are millions and millions of them in the air around us, in the soil, in the water, and even in our bodies. As I have told you, that there are some harmful microbes and these harmful microbes will cause several types of diseases in our bodies. So as you can see in the animation, these type of diseases, like it can affect your digestion, means it can go in your digestive system and it can destroy it. Next is, it can affect your immunity. As we all know, we must have to develop a strong immunity system in order to remain away from different type of diseases. And it can also affect your body weight. Means if your body weight is decreasing day by day, means there must be any microorganisms in your body that is causing the negative effect. Dear students, there are three types of microbes. Number one we have is bacteria, number two we have is virus, and number three we have is fungi. Bacteria. So bacteria are the small living cells with a new nucleus. It is present in the various forms. Next one we have is virus. So viruses are much smaller than a bacteria. It is about 1000 times smaller than the bacteria, so they can't be seen under an ordinary microscope. Means if you want to see any virus, you must have to use an electron microscope or a compound microscope in order to see the virus. So the third microbes we have is fungi. So fungi are the eukaryotic heterotrophic microorganisms that fails to show any cellular differentiation into the true tissues like roots, stem or leaf. Now the next and the very important slide we have is the modes of transmission. That what is the process through which these microbes, either bacteria, virus or fungi, travel from the one organism to another. So the microbes enters in the body by the various transmission method, and we will go through each of the method in detail. First method we are going to discuss here is the contact transmission. You can also call contact transmission as the direct transmission. The most common way for the infectious disease to spread is through the direct transfer of bacteria, viruses, or the other germs from person to another. As you can see in the picture given right here on your screen, there are two friends standing and they are shaking their hands. The one friend is having the influenza virus and the other one is shaking hands with him. So this is the contact between them. So in this way, these influenza virus are traveling from the one boy to another. So this method is known as contact transmission or the direct transmission. So dear students, if anyone is having any viral infection, so you must have to keep yourself away from the one, because you know that viral will direct transmit from one's body to another. Now let's move on to the second transmission method, and the second transmission method we have is vector transmission. You can also call it as vector borne diseases. Any illness caused by an infectious microorganism or a pathogen that is transmitted to a humans by a vector, usually by the earth. For example, if anyone is having malaria, we all know that malaria is caused by a vector, and the vector is mosquito. Now we have the third method of the transmission. As you can see, the third method of the transmission we have is the vehicle transmission. So vehicle transmission we have like airborne diseases. Pathogens suspended in the droplets or the dust can remain in air for hours to days. And these pathogens can cause several type of diseases, like the cold virus travels in the droplets when a person sneezes or when a person talks. So when a person sneezes or talks, the virus travels in the dust and suddenly it will travel to another person. So let's move on to the next slide. These are the three transmission methods. So as you can see, we have the number of the events that are causing. We have events for the hypothetical respiratory foodborne transmission. So let's focus on the cycle. As you can see in the point number one, there is the girl standing with her shopping cart in front of her, and there are a lot of fruits in her shopping cart. So when she suddenly sneezes, the virus from her mouth transfers to the food cart, and there are a lot of fruits, so the food got contaminated. When this food got contaminated, you can see point number two, this contaminated apple is now having the virus SARS-CoV-2. And when she come back to her home, her brother started eating the apple. When her brother started eating the apple without washing the apple, so shortly after consuming the unwashed contaminated food, this virus travels to his respiratory tissues in the throat. And after moving through this respiratory tissue, this virus suddenly enters in the gastrointestinal tract and spread there. So in this way, now the boy is having the viral infection. So dear student, you must have to remain away, and you don't have to touch your eyes, nose, or mouth after touching any contaminated food. So now, I hope it is clear. Now we are moving on to the next. Now we have some useful microbes. So the billions of microbes and lots more we haven't even discussed yet. Most of these microbes are either necessary for survival, they may be good for us, and they can be used for our benefit in the industry. Let's discuss an industrial benefit of these microbes. Number one we have is the production of the dairy products. Dear student, these microbes are sometimes very useful for us. As you can see, bacteria are the key players here. Bacteria helps in the fermentation, which helps in making different forms of dairy products. From milk like curd, buttermilk, butter, cheese, These are all the advantage of using these microbes. And we have the very common example of a bacteria, that is a Streptococcus. So Streptococcus is the most common genus of the bacteria that are used in the commercial production of these products. Let's move on to the second use. Second use we have is the used as insecticides. Dear students, microbes are also used in the insecticides, like certain bacterial and the fungal species are used to keep the certain insects and pests away from the crops. As you all know that there are some type of insects that can cause damage to our crops, that can cause damage to our fields. So in order to keep our crops safe, we must have to use the insecticides. And these insecticides are sometimes made up of by using these microbes. As you can see in the animation given right here on your screen, these type of insects can cause damage to our plants. So we must have to use the insecticides to keep them away from our crops. Next we have is number three use, and that is biotechnology and research. Dear students, so many labs uses bacteria, fungi, and especially viruses for their research studies. Like the non-virulent virus forms, microorganisms are injected into the subjects going through the clinical trials. This in the future helps in the development of medicines, vaccination, and the cure for many type of diseases. And they are also used in the DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, and the RNA, means the ribonucleic acid studies, also makes the use of them. Dear students, as we have discussed about the useful bacteria, now we are moving on to the harmful microbes. Harmful microorganisms not only damage the human body, but also the food we eat. Sometimes they multiply on the food and releases the toxic products, hence cause the food poisoning. To avoid from the food poisoning, food preservation is done in the various ways like pasteurization, salting, and boiling. In this way, we can preserve our food. There are given some bacterial infection symptoms. Like if you are having any bacterial infection, you will have to face symptoms like you will have the chest pain, you will have problem in speaking, and you will have flu, and sometimes you will have the fever. So these are all the symptoms, and from these symptoms you can recognize that you are having any bacterial infection. And through these type of bacterial or the viral infection, you will have diseases like you will have hepatitis, you will have chest pain, you will have influenza virus. So these are all the type of diseases that may be caused by these type of microbes. Dear students, as I have told you, there are a lot of diseases that are caused by these harmful microbes. So we must have to use any defense system. As Almighty Allah has created us, so He must have created a very diverse living organism system. So He have also told us that if you use this, you will remain yourself, you will keep remaining yourself away from these type of diseases. So the defense we have is, in conclusion, microorganisms are all around us, from the chair that we sit to the keyboard that we type. Our environment is a home to the billions of microscopic organisms. Moreover, we even have microbes living in our gut that play an important role in our digestive health. In other words, most microorganisms are not harmful, but we have to take the precautions against the ones that are. Moving on to our next slide. Dear students, I want to give some important information that, as you know, that these days coronavirus is going on, and you know this virus is very serious. It is causing several deaths all around the world. So you must have to take the safety precautions, like you must have to wear the mask and you must have to maintain the distance. So in this way, you will keep yourself away from any type of bacterial or the viral infection. I have ended my presentation. So, dear students, thank you for attending. And you may approach us in the Smart School Al Jafri campus for further questions or confusions.